So let's do another example. So we'll do a single reaction, single replacement reaction. So I have chlorine, okay, plus silver bromide. Okay, and that is going to yield bromine plus silver chloride. Okay, and again, let's write in the spot here for my coefficients. Okay, they always come in front. I can't ever write a subscript in here, even if I want to. I can't do that. That's against the rules. So again, let's just start balancing from one side. So I have two chlorines on this side, and I have only one on this side. So I'm going to write a 2 over here. And again, I might decide, I might change that and erase that. It's always best to do these in pencil. But for now, my chlorines are balanced. So I balance one thing at a time. Move across, I have silver. I have one silver on this side. And now, because I've added this 2 here, I have 2 silvers on this side. So I'm going to write a 2 here. Okay, and now my silvers are balanced. My chlorines are also balanced because I haven't changed this number, so my chlorines are balanced. And then if I look at my bromines, I have 2 bromines on this side, and it's awesome the way that works out. I have 2 bromines on this side. So really, this is quite often what happens, that when you balance one thing, the other things become balanced. Okay, so this one is now balanced. I'm not going to write the summary down below here. You can if you want to. But again, you can see that this is balanced. All right, the last example I'm going to show you is going to contain a polyatomic ion. And I'm going to start with here, aluminum plus copper 2 nitrate. And that is going to yield copper. Again, it's single replacement, so the aluminum is going to replace the copper. Okay, copper on its own. Okay, all the metals can stand on their own. Okay, they're not diatomic. Plus aluminum nitrate. And remember that I have to balance each of these electrically. So copper 2 nitrate, that's why I put the 2 down here. Aluminum has a charge of positive 3, and go down here. Now, if you find that confusing, if you are having difficulty with the naming still, go back and review the naming of polyatomic ions. So, like I've done in my other, with the other examples, I'm going to write a little line here for my coefficients, and I'm just going to start balancing from left to right. So aluminum, one aluminum on this side, go to this side, there is only one aluminum on that side. Copper, one copper on this side, and only one copper on this side. So far so good, everything is balanced. Now, when you get to polyatomic ions, these, again, remember this 2 corresponds to, I have 2 nitrogens and 6 oxygens here. And on this side, I have 3 nitrogens and 9 oxygens. So I can treat these as separate, nitrogen, oxygen, or, and do the balancing that way, or I can balance the nitrates. Different people like to do it different ways. What I'm going to do is balance the nitrogen, and hopefully that balances the oxygen as well. And we'll see how that works. So right now I have, again, I have 2 nitrogens on this side. I'm going to write this down. And on this side, I have 3 nitrogens. So what I need to do is find out what the lowest common multiple of those is. So that's going to be lowest common multiple of 2 and 3 is going to be 6. So I need to make sure that I have 6 nitrogens on this side. So what I'm going to do is put a 3 in front of this one. And that means now I have 3 coppers. I have 3 times 2 is 6 nitrogens. And I have 3 times 2, 6 times this, I have 18 oxygens. Okay. Now I'm just going to balance the nitrogens on this side. So in order to get the nitrogens to 6, I'm going to have 2 over here, because 2 times 3 gives me 6 nitrogens. Okay, and I'm going to have to check and make sure that everything else is also balanced. But let's take a look at our, I'm going to go back and balance everything out again and see what has changed. So my aluminums now, I have two aluminums on this side. Okay, so I have one aluminum on this side, I have two aluminums on this side. So that's going to force me to write a 2 here. That means that my aluminums are balanced. 2 over here, 2 over here. My coppers, I have 3 coppers over here, because 3 goes with this. So my coppers on this side, I have 3, and that's going to force me to put a 3 on this side. Okay, so now my coppers are balanced. Let's go and take a look at nitrogens now. Nitrogen, again, this is before I balanced it. I wrote down this 2. So I have 3 nitrogens times 2. So that gives me a total of 6 nitrogens now. And on this side, I have 2 nitrogens times 3 gives me a total of 6. So I take the coefficient and I multiply it by the subscript. Okay, so far, so good. And I just didn't write aluminum down here. Aluminum I have 2. Okay, so now I'm going to go to my oxygens. Now if the oxygens are balanced, then I'm finished. Okay, and I'm hoping that it should be. So I have 3 times 3, which gives me 9. Okay, multiplied by this 2. So 3 times 3 gives me 9, multiplied by this 2 gives me a total of 18 oxygens on this side. And over here, I have 2 times 3, which is 6, multiplied by 3, gives me 18 oxygens. So that was a little bit of work. Most of them are going to play out that way. When you get to double replacements, there's even more things to look at, particularly if you have a double replacement with polyatomic ions. There's a lot of calculations to look at. They aren't that difficult. The one thing that I should mention, and you'll see this in some of my other examples, in some of my other videos, because I'm going to do a number of different videos on balancing. If I have any of these numbers that I can reduce, so if they all have a common number, if I can reduce them all by 2, or if I can reduce them all in half, or divide them by 3, then I have to reduce them to the lowest common number. Okay? And also, these numbers that I put in here can only ever be whole numbers. I can never put a fraction, and I can never put a decimal, which actually I think makes the math a whole lot easier. So that's the first video that I'm going to do on balancing chemical equations. Again, I urge you to rewind the video, pause it, take notes on this, and practice. We'll be going over a number of these in class. And again, like we've done before, it's just a matter of just like we've done in the past with our naming, we need to make sure that we do a number of these because practicing is what's going to make it easier. That's what's going to make you be able to do these quickly. All right, so we will see you in class.
Science.